So we're going to talk about the Intranet reimagined with AI. So what does the Copilot actually brings in SharePoint? Because it actually brings a lot of capabilities already today. And we're going to focus on this particular presentation on the content creation experience. Now, you can actually create SharePoint agents, which are technically Copilot-powered capabilities as well. That is a bit of a different topic. Of course, that is a massively improving the Intranet experience as well, but we'll have a separate set of demos and storytelling on that one. So today we're going to focus really on the different scenarios where we're using Copilot to make the content author experience faster, better, and more efficient. And there's some really, really cool capabilities on SharePoint on that one. My name is Vesa Juvonen. I work on the Microsoft, and let's jump right into the topics of today. So I'm going to deep dive or do a slide on all of the different scenarios, and then we're going to go a specific demos in all of them so you see how this actually works in practice within the Microsoft environment. Now, I think the easiest way to actually approach this is by saying that, well, it can start, Copilot usage can actually make, in the same way as you create documents or PowerPoint presentation, you can write the prompt and you can basically say, create me a document based on, or a draft based on this information. You can do exactly the same for SharePoint pages and SharePoint news articles. And this works in a way that you go and select explicitly that I want to create a page using AI. And then you can choose optionally use a freeform prompt, or on the right side picture or the lower picture, you can actually see that we're using this kind of fill-in prompt sequencing, which is a really cool wizard, making it easy for you to create the page draft. You can also reference on the files which you want to use as a starting point, for example, PowerPoint presentations and the documents, and then all of a sudden, poof, you will get a nice document or a page out of that information. I'll come back on that one. There's a few different nuances how we are evolving this also in the future, but it's a really cool way of actually giving a starting point. So you can imagine that maybe, for example, in my case, I did a keynote last week on Collab Days Finland, and probably I should be writing some sort of a summary on what did I actually present it and share that within my team. So I can easily reference my PowerPoint presentation and say, hey, dear Copilot, create me a draft on the storytelling as I showed this presentation as part of the Collab Days Finland conference. Create me a draft news article based on that, and poof, it will create me an article. It doesn't publish that without my opinion and without my approval, but it's a draft, a starting point for me to start actually modifying things. We'll see that one in practice as I go through that one. Now, as the page has been then created, I can further evolve the page by using Copilot directly in sections. And this also works in a similar way. So you can actually use either the free text prompt, or you can use suggestions for you. So I'm going to actually pinpoint that one explicitly on the screen. And there it will provide suggestions based on the content which you already have on the page. So as you start creating new sections, you can basically say, oh, that's a useful and helpful additional suggestions, dear Copilot. Let's actually include that sections on the page. So it's basically analyzing the content of the page, what is missing, and what the Copilot thinks what typically pages should have, and then it's suggesting information. You can absolutely also reference content, documents, and all of that to create additional structures on the page as well, as a grounding or source files for the information. The right side picture on the screen is also great for explaining that it actually quite often it provides you multiple options. So you can actually select the options based on what it is actually providing for you. Like in that case, we can see the green team resources in three different ways, and then again, choose the right way and option from there. And if you don't like any of those things, you can ask it to regenerate a suggestion for you. So really getting you out of that, you know, blank page creation, giving you something to start modifying and creating the content in the SharePoint pages as well. Something also which is really, really cool is the Copilot powered FAQ web part. I will show this one in practice as well with some product example product information. But this basically means that you do not need to create the FAQ questions or categories or the answers to those questions by yourself. So we can basically say that, dear Copilot and AI, create me a product specific FAQ list, which I'm going to share with my community, with my whoever is going to access the site, with my friends and colleagues and all of that, based on this information. And the Copilot generates the information directly within the web part for you. Super cool capability. I'm going to show that one in practice in a second as well. And then the last, which I'm going to show today, is something which is actually visible already in our roadmap item, but I don't think this has been shown before today. So something new on this one. You can actually create Copilot pages or use Copilot create SharePoint pages directly from meeting notes, something which is really, really cool and quite often needed. So we all know we've been in meetings. If you have a Copilot, Microsoft Teams create a great summary on those meetings. But wouldn't it be cool if you would be able to share that summary of the meeting also with those people who don't have access on the meeting? They were not part of the meeting. They don't have permissions to the meeting. So now you can actually create a news post out of the conclusions and the outcomes of that meeting, and then optionally select if you want to have that video embedded on that page as well. But you can really, really easily and efficiently get that one moving with inside of the company. So super cool capability. But let's have a look on all of that live, because again, it's easier to understand how they work if we do that step by step. So let me go back in here. Let me enable my page. So this is just an example. I'm going to refresh just in case. Just an example site with some flexible layout examples and imaginary content. Doesn't really matter what's actually there and how the site is, because I want to show those AI capabilities in practice within this context. First of all, I'm going to start with an FAQ web part. So let's have a look on that one. I will go to the edit mode. Since I have the Copilot license, the consumers of this web part don't need to have a Copilot license, but I, as a content creator, I have the Copilot license. I can actually start using the FAQ web part because it's visible for me under the AI section. If I don't have the license, that web part is not visible or exposed to me as an option. So I will put the FAQ web part on a page. Let me actually zoom in one step forward. There we go. There's the web part, and then we kind of feed the web part with the information. So when you click the add, it will actually get some information and the files which I recently have modified. But what I'm looking into is getting a few sample things here. So a 100 series intro, I'm gonna add a 200 series intro as well. And let's add a 300 series intro. So this is just a example material on a solar panels, which you can imagine that maybe there's a value on creating an FAQ on the product information within a page. Now, that's the source files from where the questions and answers and categorization will be done. Then I'm being asked to define the purpose. So how are we gonna do this? In our case, we're gonna select product, but you could actually have event details and all of that. So it's capturing a bit different perspective on the files based on that selection. So I'm going to select product, and then I can provide additional information if needed for AI, how it should be extracting the information. Now I will create start creation. And then we can see on the left side, creating categories. This is relatively fast. Obviously, a bit depends on a day, but we're doing now a live demo in the Microsoft environment, so we should be fine. But what it does now, based on the information, how many pages, how many content, how many slides, it is analyzing that content which we provided a source file. Like in our case, we provided these three different source files and they have like 30, 40 slides altogether. And it's then creating those categories for FAQ or suggestions of the categories based on the source file, what the source file actually contained. Now, in our case, because we're talking about a solar panel source material, it is actually giving us then an analyzed set of categories, make sense, specifications, so the technical details, panel types, installation of that solar panel, maintenance, environmental benefits, and all of that. The cool thing again here is that basically it's generating the content automatically based on my intent. So it's not only there to kind of, it gives me the suggestions, and now I can guide it through. As part of the process, when it's completed with creating the categories, in a second now, here we go, I can actually choose which of the categories we want to actually talk about. So super important thing, environmental benefits, but I don't want to talk about that one in this FAQ, in this context, I can just remove it. Or I can flip the order of these things. Obviously, I can change the order. I can adjust them. I can actually even modify the content of the category. So if I want to add and manually one category, I can absolutely do that as well if that's the thing. Now, then we want to draft questions. And now we have the categories already. It's already analyzed the content. So this is a bit faster than the initial steps. But now it's actually creating the FAQ questions based on, again, the material which we feed it for the FAQ Whipper. So the content is actually created here automatically, even the questions, the typical FAQ questions. How long a typical lifespan of panel? Well, that seems okay. And again, I can modify and add questions, I can do things. And then when I'm happy with the questions and answers, it's going to draft me the answers as well. And basically, it's generating the content based on the source files, again, making my life a bit faster or easier. And now there's the answers, and I'm realizing time is flying because I'm explaining this. I'm super excited on the features. Okay, cool. But it's analyzing the answers, and then again, I can modify, I can adjust things. And as it's completed, I can decide which of the information is getting published. Also, I can modify, of course, the answers as well. So it's only generating me the draft version of the information, which is really, really cool. And I can actually also include additional questions if needed and ask it to regenerate. It will only regenerate those additional new questions, not all of the questions, which is really, really cool. So we're using, again, AI for the benefit of the content creator, improving my productivity. That's a pretty cool thing. Now, it is actually now running true, and it takes a bit longer than I was hoping for, but that's fine. It's still doing things. I'm going to stop it, but you understand how it actually works. I'm going to click stop, because I want to actually continue going somewhere else. But technically, what we can do now is to just keep it. I can modify categories, I can add questions, and then when I'm right, I can just republish the base page, and we are good to go with generated AI-generated content based on that information within the source files. So let me save the page. And then let's go to the creation of the AI-based content. So now, if you have the Copilot enabled within a SharePoint, you can create pages with AI. And this basically means that the AI behind of the scenes makes the creation of the page super, super smooth. I can start with a completely free prompt by starting to look and writing the prompt over here and adding a resource files for the better results. Or alternatively, if I go back on a template, there are certain set of templates available for me to fill in. So let's actually use the meeting newsletter. I'm going to show how this works in practice. Creating meeting newsletter page on air for a subject. And this one was SPFX. Oh, MVP. We're going to use MVP meetup. MVP meetup as the example from last week. Summary, agenda, meeting notes, follow-up tasks. That sounds good. And then I'm going to go to meetings options. And that's really cool. It is actually finding all of the meetings which I have in my calendar. And now if I go PGI in here, I can select the PGI call, which is a product group interaction call from which I want to generate the content. So the info people who don't have by default access on this information or the content of that meeting, or the recap of the meeting, I can now share that super easily within a page. Now, this works in the same way. If the source file is PowerPoint presentations, if the source file is Word or something else, or PDF documents, for example, it starts analyzing the content, analyze the source files, and creating a title section over there. And then it starts creating the content and structure based on the information what we're providing. Now, as we're waiting that to continue, I do apologize. We're going to go a few minutes long today on the demos, but that's unavoidable. So right now, as we're waiting for AI to actually process the request. Now, of course, the processing of the information and how fast it starts generating all of this stuff highly depends on how much content it has. In this case, the meeting was a 1 hour long meeting. So there's a pretty long transcript. We were showing a lot of stuff. We were speculating on the future direction of certain things, but it's basically now analyzing that transcript, making sure that the title section, content, everything else is actually working properly based on the source material. And it will take a while, but again, I can do multiple things at the same time. So I could actually work on another thing on another page or a window, and eventually I will have a great starting point with the content, which I can start modifying. And again, it does not publish anything automatically. Me as a content editor, I'm in control for creating all of this stuff, which is great. Now, hopefully it will actually do the thing in a second. Or as we're waiting for that to do that, I will also show this one. We can see this is the meeting in summary. There's nothing really NDA or secrets in here, and we are speculating on the future direction of SharePoint framework. The meeting summary here, we will actually have the create a news post option available directly in the meeting summary on the Microsoft Teams, which will redirect the user to the creation of the page as well. So now if I click this one, it will actually initiate a new page or a new page creation directly in SharePoint in the context, and it will show us the high level structure, what are we looking into doing. Now, since I initiated the creation of the page from the Microsoft Teams meetup summary, it is asking me where do I actually want to create that, so I can pinpoint that to be in any location or any file or any source content. In our case, that's my demo site, which I created. We can actually initiate this one here as well. Let's push some AI powers actually to go moving. Let's see which of these is actually faster. So if I go on this side, that's still creating tension. Hopefully this one actually processes a bit faster than the other one. Let's see how it goes. But the creation is basically automatic. We will see the creation of the page. There we go. The other one might have actually suffered some sort of a hiccup. We can see how it's actually capturing, again, the meeting as summary. It captures the restrictions. It captures the date, the key topics, what we were discussing, the meeting notes in an understandable format. Also embedding the video by default there. Again, if you don't want people to get access on the recording, you can just remove the video. The really cool thing about this auto generation based on the source file, in this case, based on the meeting summary, is that you can, of course, edit the output. So again, it is capturing all of the things, summaries, information, structure based on the layout, what it actually has, follow-up tasks based on the transcript of the page. And if I scroll back again here, it is all editable for me. So I can actually start modifying the content any way I want. I can adjust the content. If I don't agree on something, I, as a content owner or the creator of this content, still owns the publishing process. If I keep it, that's there. So it's actually getting the input available. And again, if I want something extra here, we can absolutely do sections. Where's my section? We could, if the section capability is available, we can absolutely initiate the section modifications on the Copilot as well. But you understand the point again here. We're from the content, what we're generating, we're getting the content available. And now I can modify this any way I want and get it then published for the company people. But quick update on the demos, how they actually work, and Copilot. We do have a lot of existing demos and on these available as well, and existing documentation. So please have a look on those. Super exciting capabilities on SharePoint Copilot authoring. And again, there are, for example, for FAQ web part, we explicitly call out that the content editor is only the one who needs to have the license. So we're able to see the web part, and content consumer don't need to have that. So really, really cool capabilities which are available.